I knew Fabfilter was working on something new, but I didn't expect it to be an upgrade on the now 14-year-old Twin 2 synth. Twin 3, the new version, has gotten a complete overhaul with new features which actually make me wanna jump. Fabfilter Twin 3 made the sound of the DIDI you just heard, but can also do sounds like this. And this. And many more. My first impression of the synth is that it is a bit daunting.
What's going on here?
But actually, it's quite a simple to use and straightforward synth. I will show you that when I go through all functions so you will understand how Twin 3 sounds and works. The best way to understand Twin 3 is to start from the clean preset, because it will give you the very bare bones setting you need to get going. On the left side, you find the oscillator section. You can choose from 8 waveforms and you can tune them here. All waveforms have harmonics going on, even the sine wave. Pulse width can be changed here. The representation here in this display is accurate. I double checked with other analyzers. More on what this is in a moment. Changing sync will affect the harmonics by shifting, which gets pronounced more. The last dial will do the level and panning of the oscillator. Now you can have up to 4 of these oscillators by pressing on the plus sign and quickly bypass or remove them. Adding even one oscillator already thickens overall sound. You hear that there's already interaction, phasing and oscillating happening. With 4, it's even more, of course. Simply changing the panning of these 4 and tuning will give you an already thick sounding basic synth sound. Between 2 oscillators, you also get the option to enable ring modulation. The oscillators get routed to here. And this is the EQ. Besides being a regular EQ with several EQ types, you get 11 unique filter types to alter the sound. It can get up to 4 notes. I like this, all the oscillators from here get combined and get this one EQ. Take this EQ a step further and you can set the EQ to work in series, parallel, or, very interestingly, per oscillator. This will let every EQ note work for the oscillator with the same number. There's frequency-dependent panning as well in here. Wide is left, Red is right. If you want interesting tones for every oscillator, this is how to achieve that. Now, before we get further, please make sure to subscribe to this channel to stay up to date on the latest new cool plugins and hardware. This video is made possible by DistroKid. Cover songs is probably one of the many types of songs you would love to do, but uploading to a streaming platform is always a hassle due to copyrights and required fee because you cover an original song. DistroKid makes this very easy for you by offering the option to do this all for you for $12 per song per year when you have a DistroKid subscription. Use my link in the description to get 7% off of your first year on a DistroKid. If we continue to the right, you'll see there's an entire effects section in which the oscillators and their EQ feed into. Each of the effects, except the drive, have a pop-up window where you can change settings more. And for instance, phaser can switch between phaser and flanger. Drive can be set pre or post effects, and more. Usually, the effects are the big tastemakers of a synth, but up until now, everything is pretty static. That's where the new modulation section comes into play. You might recognize this from Fabfilter plugins like Saturn 2, Timeless 3 or Volcano 3. You could call it lazy that Fabfilter has included this, but if you have the technology and developed the code, why not use it? It's a huge asset to the overall sound and it works like this. Clicking the plus will let you add several modulation sources, which includes MIDI like keyboard tracking, mod wheel and pitch bend. I'll add an XLFO. Click here and drag the line to almost any other dial in Twin 3 to modulate it. Let's go to Filter Frequency Offset. This dial will offset your set EQ by whatever you dial in and is great to modulate. Let's add another and go to Filter Peak Offset. This dial will change the peaks of the filter you have set. The XLFO can even do step sequencing by adding steps here, and then you can program something like this. I played the next loop in the beginning of this video. And this is all done with Twin 3. 6 instances in total and with basically all presets with some slight tweaking here and there. These are the sounds I used. And together it will be like this. Now to me, this is impressive. I did not do any additional processing outside of what is possible inside Twin 3. And if you can whip something up like this with only one plugin, nice. I didn't talk much about the actual sound. That is because in my opinion, Twin 3 is like a multi-tool or Swiss knife. A synth you can use to basically create any sound you want, which will work in any scenario. By itself, it's not the thickest sounding synth. For that, you need something like the Fabfilter Saturn 2 plugin to be added. And you need to put in some work to get it really thick. But maybe that's not something you're after anyway. Check my video on the Saturn 2 distortion plugin. It's displayed on screen and linked in the description below.